7-3 and number 21, Arkansas travels to Tuscaloosa to play the number 2 ranked team in the country, the Alabama Crimson Tide. They're a 20.5-point favorite. They're 9-1 on the season. But the Arkansas story is a great story that people aren't paying attention to. Head coach Sam Pittman in his second year has done a terrific job at Arkansas. They're 7-3 and they're ranked. This is a team 2 years ago that couldn't win a game in the SEC conference before COVID. If you look at the way that their quarterback, KJ Jefferson, has played this year, very physical, big quarterback that can run, that can throw, that can make plays with his arm and legs. He's got 17 touchdown passes, and he's rushed for 5 more. And he's got a terrific receiver in Treylon Burks that's going to be a first-round pick in the NFL. He's a big guy, 6'3", 225, can go up and catch the football, and is very physical. He's averaging almost 16 yards per reception, 8 touchdowns on the season. But Barry Odom, the defensive coordinator, has to do one heck of a job against Alabama because no one has really stopped this team. Yes, they did lose to Texas A&M, but nobody's really stopped Bryce Young. He's got 33 touchdowns and just 3 picks on the season. They're offensive line is playing better. Brian Robinson Jr. is running the ball better with more consistency. Plus, they just had a layup game against New Mexico State that was basically a scrimmage. But I got Alabama 20.5. I think Arkansas covers that number because they're going to run the ball. They're going to keep it close as much as they can. Alabama will get their points. Alabama will win the game, but Arkansas will cover the number. Alabama wins this game 44-27.
Well, having coached at Arkansas for 7 years, I've always followed the Hawks, and I think Pittman's done a tremendous job. That was a great win they had against LSU in the very last second. That means they've won 2 games in a row in the last second. They beat a very good Mississippi State team on the last second because of tremendous heroic efforts by Jefferson. He is special, Mark. You mentioned the 17 touchdowns, 3 interceptions, but he also runs the ball exceptionally well. And let's remember this. The running quarterback has always given Nick Saban some problems on that. I think you can't give Coach Pittman enough credit. But the one thing I will show you, Arkansas will match the physical toughness of Alabama. They're a very physical football team. They play that way. They remind you somewhat of Georgia, except they don't have the exceptional talent that Georgia has. On the other hand, Alabama is exceptional. You can't afford to overlook what Bryce Young has done at quarterback. But let me look at this, Mark. They have trouble running the football. They're having trouble with the offensive line. LSU held them to 13 yards rushing. And 2 weeks ago, Alabama struggled against rushing. And so when you have problems at the running game, you have to rely on Bryce Young, and they become, consequently, a one-dimensional football team, which is much easier to defeat. When I look at Bryce Young, I think he probably won the Heisman, he should. But the fact that they cannot run the football on a consistent basis scares me. I think Alabama wins this game, but I agree with you. They do not cover. Alabama 35, Arkansas 17. And this is the second game in a row that Arkansas has gone into a very hostile environment. Last week at LSU, they found a way to win. I don't think they find a way to win, but they do make it competitive.